Yeah, I just had to start over. Happens. Good morning. We've talked a lot about the buoyant force acting on objects submerged in fluids. Today we're going to look at the buoyant force acting on an object floating on a fluid.
Flippin' physics.
Billy, please read the problem, and Bobby, please translate.
Absolutely. A wooden sphere floats on water. Determine the percentage of the volume of the wood sphere which is below the surface of the water. The density of this water is 1.00 times 10 to the third kilograms per cubic meter, and the density of this wood is 660 kilograms per cubic meter.
The knowns are that the density of the water equals 1.00 times 10 to the third kilograms per meter cubed, and the density of the wood equals 660 kilograms per meter cubed. And we are trying to find the volume percentage of the wood sphere, which is below the surface of the water. How do we find that?
Bobby, may I add something really quick?
Sure.
Water is the fluid displaced by the object, so the density of water is also the density of the fluid displaced by the object.
Right, and wood is what the object is made of, so the density of wood is also the density of the object.
Thanks. You are welcome.
But I'm still trying to figure out what this volume percentage thing is.
The volume percentage of the wood sphere, which is below the surface of the water, is the ratio of the volume of the fluid displaced by the object to the volume of the object itself. That expressed as a percent.
Okay, so the volume of the fluid displaced by the object divided by the volume of the object equals question mark as a percent. Thanks.
Yeah.
Well done, y'all. Bo, please solve the problem.
Sure. Well, let's start with the free body diagram of all the forces acting on the wood sphere while it is floating on the water. Buoyant force is up, and force of gravity is down. Then the net force in the y direction equals buoyant force minus force of gravity. And net force in the y direction also equals the mass of the object times acceleration in the y direction. The acceleration of the sphere in the y direction equals zero. That means buoyant force equals force of gravity. Substituting in equations, we have mass of the fluid displaced by the object times acceleration due to gravity equals mass of the object times acceleration due to gravity. And
everybody brought acceleration due to gravity to the party.
Everybody brought mass. So we know the mass of the fluid displaced by the object equals the mass of the object. We also know density equals mass over volume, so mass equals density times volume, which we can substitute in our equation to get the density of the fluid displaced by the object times the volume of the fluid displaced by the object equals the density of the object times the volume of the object.
And the volume of the fluid displaced by the object equals the volume of the object. Therefore, everybody brought volume to the party.
The volume of the fluid displaced by the object and the volume of the object are only the same when the object is submerged in the fluid. That's not true here.
All right. My bad, dog.
Sure, dog.
Okay. Because the sphere is not submerged in the water, the volume of the fluid displaced by the object is not equal to the volume of the object. And we can solve for the ratio we are looking for. The volume of the fluid displaced by the object over the volume of the object equals the density of the object over the density of the fluid displaced by the object. We have all those numbers, so 660 over 1,000 equals 0.66. That means 66% of the wooden sphere is below the surface of the water.
Exactly. Incidentally, this ratio is referred to as the specific gravity of the substance. Specific gravity is a dimensionless quantity defined as the ratio of the density of a substance to that of a standard substance. Typically, for solids and liquids, that standard substance is water at 4 degrees Celsius, which is what we are using here.
Okay, 0.66 is the specific gravity of this wood material. Cool?
Yeah. Okay. So we know 66% of the volume of the sphere is below the surface of the water. That means 34% of the wooden sphere is above the surface of the water. And realize, the shape of the floating object is irrelevant. No matter what shape it is, 34% of a solid object with this density will be above the surface of the water as it floats on the water. Okay, do we want to take measurements to make sure the physics works?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
All right, here we go. The diameter of this wooden sphere is 50.7 millimeters, which we can convert to 0.0507 meters, and then divide by 2 to get the radius of the sphere to be 0.02535 meters. We know the object is a sphere, so the volume of the object equals the volume of a sphere, or 4/3 pi times radius cubed. We can substitute our radius into that equation to get 6.82374 times 10 to the negative 5 cubic meters for the volume of the wooden sphere. We are going to determine the volume of the wooden sphere, which is above the surface of the water, using an equation from Wolfram Math World. It is the volume of the cap of a sphere equals 1/3 times pi times h squared times the quantity 3 times radius minus h, where h is the vertical height of the cap, or the vertical distance from the surface of the water to the top of the sphere. We can take that measurement. H is 2.0 centimeters, or 0.02 meters. And we can substitute values for radius, r, and vertical cap height, h, into the equation for the volume of the cap. And that calculates out to be 2.34782 times 10 to the negative 5 cubic meters. And we can take the volume of the cap and divide it by the volume of the object to get 0.3441, or roughly 0.34, which is 34%. And that is exactly what we predicted it would be. I think it is time to say,
the physics works! The physics works, the physics works. The physics works, the physics works.
Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.